We are thinking about simple ways to analyze and model parts. How should I design this drill press table? Let's take a closer look. The table is basically designed as a cantilever beam, as you can see from the side view. To make it light and stiff, it is shelled inside with ribs. It mounts to the support bracket on the end face. Because of this function and fit, I decided to locate the datum coordinate system at the intersection of this mounting face, the tabletop surface, and the center line of the drill press. I created three sketches to define the basic shapes of the table. A plan sketch from the top view defines the size of the table and the layout of the hole and slots. The profile view shows the table shape from the side. A third sketch defines the extra thickness added to stiffen the mounting face. All three sketches are sketched on the planes of the datum coordinate system. Here are the sketch features in the part navigator. I extrude the outer boundary of the plan sketch without draft angle. Next, I extrude the profile sketch with the Boolean intersect option. I next added the large edge blends because I want this blend on both sides of the shell. I added the draft angle on the sides using the top surface as the stationary plane. Then I hollowed the part with the shell command, removing the bottom faces. I extrude the mounting face sketch. To select the sketch with one click, I used the Follow Fillet option. And for the end limit, I selected Extended Face, and I choose the inside face. I extrude the detailed table slots and center hole shapes using the through all end limit and a Boolean subtract option. I created a lip around the edges of the slots using a two-sided offset. Next, I add draft angle to the sides of this lip. To add a rib, I created a datum plane and sketched a single angled line. I used the rib command with the option Parallel to Section Plane, because the rib is parallel to the plane of the sketch, not perpendicular to it. I reflect the rib using the mirror face command. This is simpler than using mirror feature for two reasons. I only need to select the faces, not the sketch and datum plane as I would need to for mirror feature. It also creates a smaller file size. The next to last step is to add holes. I add a counterboard hole at the center of the arc of the mounting face. The last step is to add the final cosmetic edge blends. Let me just step through these first three edge blend features. To blend the top of the ribs, I select the face using the curve rule of rib top face edges. Now I can blend around the rest of the rib, selecting a tangent chain of edges. I have followed the same feature outline as in the last videos. Let me point out three reasons for this outline. First, this outline is a way of thinking about how to model a part. Second, it is also a best practice for a logical feature order that will be understandable by someone who needs to edit this model. The third thing we have not talked about yet is that by following this order, we reduce the chances of unnecessary dependencies that can make it harder to edit a model.